Fundamentals of software testing. When to stop testing? It's a good question. When we should stop testing? And the answer is very simple. Never. There is always something to test. Software is never perfect. So with proper testing, you could always improve the software. But in real life, the software is definitely not tested forever. And when it's released, it should not stop testing and improving process completely. So basically, nowadays, when all the software is somehow related to internet connections, so we need to improve them, fix the security issues and such. So there is quite often some testing needed when some library or some parts of the software is improved to meet the new security standards, etc. So in real life, the testing has to meet the acceptance level before the product can be released. Of course, customer needs to be happy. can you build high quality software with low price and in fast pace? So there is this kind of a project management triangle. There is actually a Wikipedia page of this, quite large page if you want to read it, but the thing is that when you are aiming for quality, you need to have some kind of a scope for the project and time schedule and some money involved in it. And if we want to, let's say, make it faster, then we need to probably put more money in it, or we need to cut the scope a little bit. If we want to lower the costs, then probably the time frame might be longer, or the scope might be reduced. And this can also be presented like this: 3 items, cost, time, and money, and you can only pick 2. So if you don't have money at all, then you probably need to, you will lose money, lose time, so the software is not ready in time or something like that. If the quality is not important, then the software is ready in time, and it will cost what is it supposed to cost. This kind of a interpretation can be made from this diagram. Short case description. I was in a project with which had a fixed deadline. So there was a deadline in the end of the year. It needed to be done, and it could not be missed in any case. So absolutely not. It had to be ready in the end of December. That was the case. There was no way to move the release date. So the time part was fixed, it was selected, and as projects usually do not have unlimited budget, in this case there was a lot of money involved, but the budget was not unlimited, of course. So something had to be done with the quality. It had to be somewhat flexible. So actually the scope was shrunk a bit, so quite a bit, and the software was released before the Christmas, so it was actually released a bit early than was the final deadline. And after the release, the project was kept going on for a year after that, basically, and all the missing features were included to the software to the software after the release. This also meant that some things were tested before the release, then they were redone properly, and then tested in the final form. So money was spent to do the same job twice. So we were not getting basically the first time the quality we were hoping for, but as the deadline was fixed, we were meeting that, and there was no such increase in cost part, but the quality was, in that sense, it was bad because we had to do some parts again. This is actually a multi-case study which you can read from the article, The Role of the Customer in Agile Project, a multi-case study, and it's written by me and Jussi Kasurinen, and you can find it just by googling it. It is provided in my homepages for free, so you can read it there if you are interested. So there are projects that have a fixed deadline or fixed features that have to be before the software can be released. And this is an issue because earlier it was mentioned that how two-thirds of the software projects are not delivered in time. So there are problems. And when the deadline is fixed, something else needs to be changed. And quite often, time resources are taken from testing because it's the somewhat last part in the software project. And then one just tests as much as possible, and that's about it. You have the deadline, and you have to release the software. And then when the key element is feature-rich application, so you need to have these and these features. They cannot be skipped. Then the deadline is probably flexible, and basically developers can just keep developing as long as it takes to make those features, or as long as someone is paying if the contract is not fixed cost. So this is of course one way. If the contract is somewhat open-ended, then the vendor can just develop, and the customer is paying money all the time, which is not the case how it should be. And if the contract is the fixed cost, vendor probably wants to release the software as quick as possible, of course. So then the customer's role is to make sure that the acceptance testing is taken care of properly. And that's the one thing that you are now learning in this course. If you are in a customer organization buying software, you need to really know how to make sure that the software is tested properly in acceptance testing. So that's one of the key points, because if a customer doesn't test the software properly, then they can pay software and say to the vendor that we are happy with this, and then later on they find out that, oh, these are missing from the software, this is still very buggy, and then they need to spend more money to make fixes to those parts if they have already accepted the software. There will be a video about these cases next week. So, in one picture, this last slide, basically, usually there is a plan. There should be a plan every case in every software project. Here is just this kind of a project that has a design, development, and testing phase. So the design starts in the beginning of the year, and soon after the actual coding starts. And then the testing starts. This is like internal testing, and then there is also customer involved in the end of the project. This is real hard designing, and then there is just slight designing in April and May. And in the end of the year, it is released, and then the software begins its life in production. So this is the plan. And then the reality, if we have to fix it, fixed deadline, so it needs to be released in the December. So design, it makes takes a little bit more time, and the development can start only in March, and then the testing can start in May, and the customer is and the software is such ready only in October, so that customer can be involved in the testing, and they have only 2 months time to do the acceptance testing, and then they are then the software is brought to production. So there is a big difference. Customer can do 4 months testing, or customer can do 2 months testing with a little not meeting the deadlines here and there. So probably in this case the scope is a little bit lower than it was supposed to be, or the software is has much more bugs in it. Or if we are not using fixed deadline, we are using fixed features, we want to have all the necessary features, then we still are missing the deadlines here. The development starts a month late and the testing starts a month 2 months later. Then we go with the release to February next year, so there is a 2 month more being carried out development and testing, and then the software is released. So someone is paying these 2 months. So there are guys doing programming who is paying for these 2 months. It depends on the contract what kind of a decision have been made. But it has to be noted that there are people doing work and someone needs to pay their salary. But this is software development in real life, so who knows what kind of a development project one ends up to do with. There are also other ways to end testing besides deadline and feature completion, where customer has accepted the work. There are other reasons to stop testing. For example, we are running out of money. So basically, the project has some money, and if it's run out, then there is no one doing testing. So it can end up in situation where the software is released and it has quite a lot of bugs, or then there can be decision that project gets cancelled. So that's also one possible way to end the testing. Or then management or the customer decides that the product is ready. You are doing testing and customer sees that okay, that's enough. We are happy with the software and it's ready. Or bug rate falls below certain level. So there are new bugs coming, but only here and there. So you decide that okay, we are now the code base is strong enough, or all the test cases pass. If there are like only 10 test cases, then it's easy to pass them. But if the test cases are properly done and there are a lot of test cases and they are all passing, then the software is pretty much really ready to be released. So that's of course one way to end the testing. And all the critical and major bugs have been fixed and regression testing is passing, then it's quite safe to release the software. There might be some minor bugs, but they are just minor ones and they can be fixed after the release if they need fixing at all. It depends what kind of a software is it. So there is this kind of a diagram where we have a risk level and how much we are doing testing, how big percent that of the code is covered in the testing. So basically here we have quite big risks, but we are not spending resource on testing. And here we are spending a lot of resources on testing and the risk is very small. So hey, the sweet spot is here. So you might be ending the testing somewhere here when there has been enough testing, so the risk level has been decreased to acceptance level. So and this is of course depends. If we are doing a software nuclear power plant, then probably we will do high cost testing so that we will reduce the risk to very minimal. But if you are releasing let's say, programming exercise work in a university course, then the testing can be here. What I have learned that some students not always test systematically. So then there is a risk that the lecturer or teaching assistant who tests the software decides that, oh my God, this is not working. So there is really a risk. Yeah. As a conclusion, testing is ending in one way or another. And hopefully it is continuing still in the maintenance phase, because there is a lot of libraries and such to be updated once in a while. And still around 2/3 of the software projects are not delivered in time. And this sadly means that testing is something that is skipped in the end if it's needed. So it's a sad truth. With project with fixed deadline or fixed features or fixed budget, they are considering the testing a bit from different angle. So you have to always remember in what kind of a project you are in. Do you have a fixed deadline or do you have a budget that cannot be increased, or what's the thing with the project?